explanation about this particular piece before we try to start playing it for all of you. We have a couple things that we want to point out and hopefully make your listening experience make more sense. This is not a piece that is like the march where it's easy to understand, we all get it, it's all in two, it's all in major, we're happy about it, great thing, right? This piece expresses much more than, you know, the simple joy of the march that we just played, although the march is lots of fun and we get something from it. This really deals with the invasion of Prague in 1968. So you're going to hear various sounds, and Karl Husa was a, he's still alive, is a Pulitzer Prize winning composer. So he expresses things very deeply in a lot of different ways, and I'd like to just point out some things so you have things to listen for as we go through the piece. First of all, this is based off a Hussite war song, or a hymn rather, that has brought the people of this region together for literally thousands of years, because you've got many people have conquered and left Prague and then reconquered, and it's changed hands so many times I don't think they can keep straight who actually lives there anymore. But they, this song helps rally these people like a patriotic song would for us. The interesting thing that Husa does is he puts it first in the timpani. So Reed, could you play the opening thing? Now it's all fragmented through his part, and we'll hear more of it later on. Then we get this melancholy type of bird singing as the invasion is going to start here, and we hear that first in the piccolo. Angie, would you play that opening? Not what you're always expecting from a bird, right? The piece is not based on a scale, like a major scale like the march was. It's actually based on all 12 tones of the chromatic scale, so that you hear throughout this, and Angie played many of them through that little figure that we hear come back regularly, and the first movement begins and ends with the little bird, and contrasted with the hymn. So listen for those things. The next thing is we get this idea of signaling and warning. The city of Prague is a city of towers, and the towers looked out so they could see invading armies or fires, things like that, coming at them. And so there are several things that represent that. The first thing I'm going to ask Scott and Rachel to play the little figure that is a warning figure. It first appears in the oboes here. Okay, that's a little fragment of it. There's a much longer one that you'll hear in just a minute. Then we contrast that with fanfares that we'll hear. Fanfares are traditionally played by the trumpet, so he doesn't hide it anywhere. It's in the trumpets. So we get the fanfare. So you'll notice that one right away, because it will sound exactly the same as what they just played. Right, guys? Lady? Good. Okay, they played it really well then, so we want to encourage that. Saxophones. In Baroque opera especially, they would have laments. You would lament the death of someone, or you would lament this horrific event in your life, okay? What Husa does is he takes it here, and he puts it in a more far-out kind of way, but the saxophones are actually the main focus of the aria, so we're going to play a little bit of that theme.
Thank you.